information.
All new at 6, unintended consequences tonight of DeKalb County's early retirement. And they are expensive. More than 800 county employees took early retirement last spring. Now that measure, the county expects, will save money in the long run. But right now, many departments say their overtime spending is way over budget. Channel 2's Aaron Coleman is live at the DeKalb County Jail with a look at what it all means. Aaron.
Monica, I sat down with the sheriff today, and he tells me every single one of his detention officers who work in the jail are now on mandatory overtime. They are trying to make up for all of the employees that took an early out. And as you might imagine, that OT is now adding up.
But it's frustrating because these are times we have never seen before.
Sheriff Tom Brown lost 89 of his employees to DeKalb's early retirement option, the most, he says, out of any county department.
We're already underfunded in overtime already. We already have overspent our overtime budget by over a little over $1 million.
And he's not alone.
CEO Ellis met with all the judges, including the sheriff, last week and told him that the administration certainly understood those needs and that we would address them.
DeKalb's new chief operating officer, Richard Stogner, has only been on the job for about 2 weeks, but admits the early retirement option had problems from the outset. The county decided to use early retirements rather than layoffs as a way to fill a big budget gap.
I do not think that we adequately addressed the impact of it before we actually got into it.
There was not a planning for it, and it's caused tremendous problems.
District 1 Commissioner Elaine Boyer proposed this budget adjustment that would give departments extra money to make up the difference. Commissioners were supposed to vote on it on Tuesday, but it's been pushed back 2 more weeks. The process for everyone, they say, has been frustrating.
If we run out of money, then I'm going to come back to the board and say, well, I've run out of money, and I'm expecting them to find the money for me to operate this place.
Now, the sheriff says another part of the problem is that he can't get enough qualified applicants in front of him fast enough. So until he does, you're going to have that mandatory overtime. The COO assures me that eventually all the departments will get the money they need. Reporting in DeKalb County, Aaron Coleman, Channel 2 Action News.